In last night's katha, we described Hanuman Swami's entry into the Ashoka Vatika, his meeting with Vibhishan, who directed him the whereabouts of Sita Devi. Hanumanji witnessed the onslaught of Ravan against Devi Sita, and also the powerlessness of Ravan against Sita Devi. One blade of grass separated him from Sita Devi. That blade of grass placed upon the ground between herself and Ravan prevented Ravan, my dear friends, from in any way attacking Sita Mata in any manner. Such was the power of Divine Mother Sita Devi. Hanumanji, who witnessed all of this, said to her after Ravan had departed, that, O Mother, you who are Jagat Janani, Mother of this universe, you who have the power to single-handedly destroy Ravan and the host of demons that live here in Lanka, you, O Devi, submit yourself to this Charitra, to this Ram Leela, in order to bring about the demise of Ravan. And so, my dear friends, we had reached that point where, of course, he spoke to her in this manner. He delivered that ring on to her, and also the very important message that Sri Ram is building that bridge across the ocean to march his army into Lanka. And so tonight, as we continue with our katha, my dear friends, Hanumanji would eventually meet with Ravan after, of course, he has spoken with Devi Sita Mata. But firstly, of course, we join together in dhyan and meditation. Invocation mantras tonight will be chanted by Pandit Vasudev Maharaj. And let us all assume that posture of devotion, of meditation, of dhyan, as we join together with Pandit Vasudev in these invocation mantras.
We clasp our hands together. As we close our eyes, we focus our mind on the form of Sri Ram, accompanied by Sita Mata and Hanuman Baba. Oh, 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 Hari Om, Sri Ganeshaya Namaha, Sri Saraswatiye Namaha, Sri Vakritunda Mahakaya Surya Koti Samaprava Nirvingam Kuru Mereva Sarvakarishu Sarvira Akanda Mandalakaram Vyaptam Nena Chiracharam Tatparam Darishitam Nena Tasmai Shri Guru Venama Guru Brahma Guru Vishnu Guru Devo Maheshwara Guru Saikshat Parabrahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namah Jayanti Mangala Kali Badrakali Kapalini Durga Chama Shivadatri Swahasurai Namastute Saraswati Mahabhage Vidhi Kamali Luchini Vidya Rupi Vishalakshi Vidyam Dehi Namastute Ramaye Rama Badraye Ramachandraye Velase Raghunathaye Nathaye Sitaye Pate Namah Apadam Paritaram Dataram Sarva Samparam Lokabhiramam Sri Ramam Bhuyo Bhuyo Namamyaham Ram Ramiti Ramiti Rame Rame Manorame Sahasranam Tatulyam Ram Nam Varaname Om Dasharataya Vidmahe Sita Vallabhaya Dhimahi Tanno Ram Prachurayat Om Janakinandinyaya Vidmahe Bhumijaya Dhimahi Tanno Sita Prachurayat Anjane Sutaya Vidmahe Hanumantaya Dhimahe Tanno Hanuman Prachurayat Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Durga Rupena Sanshita Namastase 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 Namo Namah Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Daya Rupena Sanshita Namastase 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 Namo Namah Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Shraddha Rupena Sanshita Namastase 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 Namo Namah Om Anjani Sutaya Vimahe Vayu Putraya Vimahe Tanno Hanuman Prachurayat Bolo Pavana Putra Hanuman Ki Jai Siyapati Ramachandra Ki Jai
Saraswati Mata Ki Jai. Hanumanji had asked Sita Devi's permission. Mother, now that I have met you, now that I have spoken to you, I have traveled a great distance, O Devi, to arrive here. in Lanka. And we had described in a previous night's katha, of course, how he assumed that huge form. And of course, with the grace and blessings of Pavan Devata, my dear friends, he was able to fly across the ocean and arrive in Lanka. And so he's saying to her mother, I have had a very long and difficult journey. And seeing these beautiful fruits upon these trees, and we describe the beautiful Ashok Vatika, a beautiful park. And apart from the Ashoka trees, my dear friends, there are also many fruit trees there that are, you know, filled with succulent, delicious fruits. And he's saying to her, before I return to my Lord Sri Ramchandra, with your blessings, with your permission, O Mother, permit me to partake of these delectable fruits, and then after I have appeased my hunger, I shall return to Sri Ram. And so she says to him, O Pavan Putra, you have my blessings, you have my permission, but beware, in this grove of Ashoka trees, in this Ashoka Vatika, there also dwells many demons, many rakshasas. These demons, O Pavan Putra, are very powerful. They're very dangerous and merciless individuals. Be careful, O Hanumanji, as you partake of these fruits. And so, my dear friends, he went now to these several fruit trees and he began now to eat the delicious fruits that grew there. And someone alerted Ravan. O Ravan, there's a vanar, a powerful vanar in the Ashok Vatika. He is plundering the trees and partaking of the fruits that are there. And so Ravan had dispatched several of his soldiers, including Meghanad, to remove Hanumanji from that grove of fruit trees. And my dear friends, a fierce battle had erupted between Hanumanji and Meghanath and the members of that army. Sri Hanuman Swami, by invoking the blessings of Sri Ram, whilst he's fighting them, my dear friends, he's chanting the mantras in glorification of Bhagwan Sri Ramchandra. And this gives him the power, my dear friends, to face that challenge, to face that battle. And so he would uproot entire trees and hurl it at these demons. Let us listen to some of these mantras, powerful shlokas and stotra, my dear friends, that energized Hanumanji, that gave him that shakti, that power, you know, to fight these fierce rakshasas. At one point in time, taken an entire tree, he hurled it at Meghanath. He, Meghanath, fell unconscious upon the ground. We shall find out, my dear friends, what becomes of Hanumanji in this fierce battle after we listen to these mantras chanted by Pandit Vinayak Maharaja.
Rasanam chandasam api mangalanam chakartaram devani vinayakam bhavani shankarau vande shraddha vishwas rupinau yabhyam vinana pasyanti siddha swantastamishwaram vande bodhamayam nityam Gurum Shankar Rupinam Yamashrito Hi Vakropi Chandra Sarvatra Vanyate Sita Rama Gunagrama Punyaranya Viharina Vande Vishwedha Vigyana Kavishwara Kapishwara Udhava Stiti Sanghara Karinim Kleshaharinim Sarvashreya Skarim Sita Natoham Rama Vallabham Yanmaya Vashavarti Vishamakhilam Brahmadi Devasura Yatsatvaram Rashaiva Bhati Sakalam Rajoyata Hir Brahma Yatpara Plavamekameva Hibhavam Bodhisthitir Shavatam Vandeham Tamashesha Karana Param Ramakyam Isham Harim Nana Purana Nigamagama Sammatam Yad Ramayane Nigaritam Kwasidanya Topi Swantaha Sukhaya Tulasi Raghunatha Gata Bhasha Nibandhamati Manjala Matanoti.
Bolia Sita Pati Ramachandra Ki Jai. And you must understand, devotees, our mantras, the mantras we chant, are very powerful. It is the same mantras that Hanumanji utilized, the great rishis and munis utilized, the sant and the sadhus utilized, my dear friends, to empower themselves. We too can similarly empower ourselves, my dear friends, by chanting and by listening to these powerful stotra, my dear friends, that brought success and victory to Hanumanji. And so, my dear friends, he had vanquished the soldiers of Ravan's army. It is then that Meghanath utilized the Brahma Astra. This is a very powerful weapon of Lord Brahma. Hanumanji actually had the power to repel this powerful Brahma Astra. But owing to the fact that it is the weapon of Lord Brahma, out of reverence, my dear friends, he bowed his head and allowed himself to be subdued by that powerful Brahma Astra weapon. Remember the first night of this Yagya, for those of us who were not here, when Lord Brahma gave Vardhan or blessings to Hanuman Swami as a young child, he had said to him, O Pavan Putra, never again will you be affected by any weapon, be it the Vajra that Raja Indra had struck Hanuman Swami with, or any other weapon. O Hanuman Swami, you will have immunity, you will have power over all weapons. And so Hanumanji merely allowed himself to be subdued by this powerful Brahma Astra weapon. And even as he was bound, my dear friends, and taken before Ravan, in the courtyard, in the palace of Ravan, as he was brought before Ravan, who sat upon the throne of Lanka, there Hanumanji was singing the glories of Sri Ram.
Ram Ramaiya, bole de bhaiya, man ki khivariya hon re.
Even in the face of these enemies of Sri Ram, yet my dear friends, this did not prevent him from chanting the name of Bhagwan. In the face of the most severe adversity he had encountered, he did not allow fear to overtake his mind and his thoughts. Yet, my dear friends, his mind and thoughts were centered on that supreme Paramatma, Bhagwan Sri Ram.
Ram Ramaiya, bol re bhaiya, man ki khivariya hon re. Ram Ramaiya, bol re bhaiya, man ki khivariya hon re. Ram naam hi sang rahega, saath na jaaye mahal.
agni vayu pani nashvara duniya ani jani. The earth, the fire, the wind, the water, all is controlled by that divine Lord Shri Ram. He controls all the elements. This entire universe, my dear friends, is under his control. And so Hanumanji's glorification of Sri Ram, that if the Lord controls all, including this demon, this Rakshas, that has ordered his soldiers to bound me, to tie me, and present myself before this demon, Ravan, then my Lord, he's saying to Ravan, also has control over you. This is what we must understand, my dear friends. There is no force that is more powerful than Bhagwan himself. You know, sometimes we become very superstitious and fearful as a people. One lady came to me, she says, Baba, in front of my home this morning by the gate, I saw sindoor and haridi and red flowers and all sorts of things. And, you know, and she has a little enmity with the neighbor. I feel somebody is trying to do me something. And I explained to her, the bhakta, the devotee of Bhagwan, has nothing to fear. We chanted Bajrangban, Bhut Pisash, Nikatana Hiyawe. All of these, my dear friends, problems and adversities and so on, are destroyed when we invoke the blessings of Bhagwan. No force, my dear friends, is more powerful than the blessings of Bhagwan. When you have secured Bhagwan's blessings, my dear devotees, nothing, no one can harm you. And so even as he presents himself in the presence of Ravan, he declares to Ravan that I am not fearful of you, O Ravan, despite the fact, my dear friends, he's surrounded by these band of demons, Rakshasas, who are equipped with weapons, my dear friends, and who await the bidding, the instructions of Ravan. Let us go to this Shaupai, as we shall find out now how this meeting between Hanuman Swami and Ravan transpires. कवनते कुईसा केही के बल धाले ही बन कीसा कीधव श्रवण सुनेहि नहि मोहि देखव अति असंक सत तुहि. Who are you, O Vanar? Remember, Hanumanji is bound, he is tied by ropes, and he is present now before Ravan. Ravan is seated upon the throne of Ayodhya, and he is asking him, who are you, O Vanar, and whose power do you rely upon to bring such destruction to Lanka? There is no Vanar that possesses the strength and capability of you. Tell me, whose power do you depend upon to have such might and power? Hanumanji responds, by whose grace Lord Brahma created this world, by whose power Lord Vishnu preserves this world, and by whose blessings Lord Shiva reabsorbs or destroys this world, it is his power that I depend upon. All of us, my dear friends, depend upon his power. Not only Lord Brahma and Lord Vishnu and the Lord Shiva. All of us. If you were to withdraw his power, and his power is the Jivatma. Remember, he is the Paramatma, the source of all atmic energies. And within you and I, my dear friends, he has put that Jivatma that causes us to be alive. The moment he withdraws the Jivatma from this Manushareer, what becomes of it? We are dead. Marna ho gayi. The life force leaves this Manushareer, this physical body, my dear friends, when that Jivatma is recalled by Bhagwan, who is the Paramatma. He assumes, O Ravan, various forms for the protection of the devis and devatas, the sant and the sadhus, and to support dharma. In the pages of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna declares, yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bhadaka abhyotanam dharmasya tadatmanam shrijamyaham. Paritranam sadhunam vinashaya cha duskritam dharma sanstapanarthaya shambhavani yuge yuge. So it's the very same thing that Lord Krishna declares in the pages of Srimad Bhagavad Gita is what Hanuman Swami is emphasizing to Ravan. It is that same Lord whose power that I rely upon, O Ravan, that assumes this form of Sri Ram to destroy sinfulness, adharma, unrighteousness, and to restore righteousness and dharma on its firm footing. He is the protector of all bhaktas, all devotees, the sant and the sadhus. It is that same Supreme Lord who destroyed Kara and Dushan. Now these are also demons whom Sri Ramchandra has already destroyed. It is that same Lord who has destroyed that powerful Vali. He is incomparable. He is matchless, O Ravan. The slightest exercise of his power, O Ravan, brings about widespread disaster and destruction in this world. I advise you, O Ravan, to pay respect, to submit yourself, to seek the forgiveness of that Lord. Take my advice. Take heed of my advice, O Ravan. Remove this abhiman, shed this maya. You are blinded, O Ravan, by your arrogance. These are very powerful words, you know, my dear friends. But would Ravan listen to the words, the advice, wonderful advice that Hanumanji gives to him? Seek the forgiveness of Sri Ram, whose grace and blessings enables this entire universe, O Ravan, to function. Without his blessings, even you, O Ravan, would not be able to sit upon this throne in Lanka and govern over this kingdom of Lanka. But what prevents him? You know, he laughs at Hanumanji. He ridicules Hanuman Swami. Are you trying to become my guru, O Vanar? Do you think you are so worthy enough to become my guru? He laughs at him. He ridicules him. Have you forgotten, or are you not aware, O Vanar, of my own power? These are the words of Ravan, despite receiving such wonderful advice. My dear friends, as we say, it passed through one ear and fly out the next side without making any impact, being of any benefit to Ravan.
Man ki aankhe khol baba, man ki aankhe khol.
So to answer that question, what prevents him from understanding, from acting upon the advice, from accepting the wonderful words spoken by Hanuman Swami? This bhajan says that veil of Maya prevents us from seeing, from understanding the errors of our ways. Man ki aankhe khol, it says open your eyes. Not the two physical eyes, you know. The two physical eyes are for merely walking around and navigating where we go to ensure we do not run into the wall and the post and so on. The third eye, man ki aankhe khol, that third eye of consciousness that enables us to understand our purpose and place in this world and that relationship that we have with the divine. There are many, my dear friends, just like Ravan in today's world, who have become blinded by that ego, by that abhiman, by that delusion. And although the two eyes, the two physical eyes are open, my dear friends, many live in this world oblivious, blind, my dear friends, as Ravan had been blinded by that ego and by that abhiman.
Man ki aankhe khol baba, man ki aankhe khol, man ki aankhe khol baba, man ki aankhe khol, man ki aankhe khol baba, man ki aankhe khol, man ki aankhe khol.
Sab zor laga kar tan man ka sab zor.
We must ensure, my dear devotees, that we do not allow ourselves to become affected by the same disease, the same type of blindness that Ravan suffered from. That prevents us, my dear friends, from discharging our duties, the observance of the various religious festivals, coming to the mandir. You know, that too is a form of blindness. When someone cannot see and understand the importance of being at the mandir and being part of the yagya and engaging in fasting and pujan and so on, my dear friends, all of this occurs not through the blindness of the two eyes, you know. When the two eyes begin to give problems, you get a chasma, you get the glasses. If the eyes need cleaning, you clean the eyes and so on, you get the eye drops. That type of vision, the divine vision, which is called Divya Drishti. That is the vision, my dear friends, that activates the third eye. So all of us have three eyes. That may sound funny to some, eh? But we all have three eyes. The two physical eyes for navigating and seeing where we are going. And the third eye, the trikut, my dear friends, that third eye of consciousness, of spiritual awareness. But the optician and the glasses can't do anything for that eye. Only your devotion to God begins to activate, my dear friends. When you do your Surya Namaskar in the morning, you close your eyes and you worship the sun, Surya Narayan Swami, you feel that tingling, that energy, my dear friends, between the eyebrows. The third eye is right there. But for the most part, it remains dormant. Just like a volcano remains dormant, my dear friends, there's great power, great energy beneath the surface of the volcano. Great energy is there, you know, waiting to burst forth. So too, my dear friends, there is also great energy within us. That spiritual energy, my dear friends, is also dormant because we are not taking the right steps to activate that third eye. So, man ki aankhe khol, open the eyes so that we see, my dear friends, that Divya Drishti brings that divine sight and understanding of our purpose and place in this world. Let us go to this next shofai. This wonderful discussion is taking place between Ravan and Hanumanji. He has asked, O Vanad, who are you? Who gives you this power? And so Hanumanji is responding to this question of Ravan. And as he speaks, Ravan is becoming more and more enraged, you know. Words of wisdom, wonderful advice, but my dear friends, instead of becoming calm and understanding the error of his ways, he's becoming more and more incensed, more and more angry. You know, sometimes you try to speak to a person, you try to reason with a person, there is some incident, there is some confrontation, and you're giving wonderful advice to that individual, but despite the fact that you are speaking in a nice way, trying to reach out to that individual, all your words, my dear friends, are not having that impact, that positive impact upon that individual. Because he's blinded by rage and anger, what happens? He's becoming more and more angry despite the words of wisdom that you are speaking to that individual. This is what is playing out, my dear devotees, between Hanumanji and Ravan.
Ram charan
चरण पंकज उरधरहु लंका अचल राज तुम करहु ऋषि पुलश्च जस बिमल मयंका तेहि ससि महजनी होहु कलंका. ओ रावण, दैट लॉर्ड श्री राम इज ऑल फॉरगिविंग. Whatever transgressions you have committed thus far, even your abduction forcibly of Sita Devi here and holding her as a prisoner of yours, even this would be forgiven if you go before that Lord and seek his forgiveness. All this wealth that you possess, all of these beautiful palaces that you own, this power of governance over Lanka, O Ravan, even this is on account of the blessings of Bhagwan Sri Ram. Lord Krishna says, what is yours today was someone else's yesterday, and we become someone else's tomorrow. We become deeply engrossed in this sense of ownership, that this section is mine, that section is yours. Bhagwan says, nahi, in reality, nothing belongs to us. What you have is merely entrusted in your hands for a short period of time. All of these are the wonderful lessons, my dear friends, that Hanumanji is teaching to Ravan. Even this wealth that you possess, this great palace that you own, has merely been entrusted in your hands for a short period of time. Do not develop the sense of attachment, O Ravan. Instead, turn to that Lord, surrender to that Lord. Remember, O Ravan, the greatness of the lineage from which you have come. Do not discredit and disrespect your great ancestors. Your grandfather was none other than the holy sage, the great Rishi Pulastya. Pulastya Muni, my dear friends, was the grandfather of Ravan. You know, how can someone who is so great and so powerful and so divine, such as Pulastya Muni, have a grandson such as Ravan, who is the exact opposite of Pulastya Muni? Pulaschi Muni is always performing puja and chanting Rama in the sun. And Ravan, my dear friends, is the opposite of this. Never making time for God, you know, and always engaging in hurting others and bringing distress and difficulties to others. You, O Ravan, would become like a stain, a blot upon the wonderful lineage, the wonderful ancestry, the wonderful ancestors who have come before you. Your actions, your bar karma, O Ravan, puts a stain upon these wonderful individuals. Blessed is that mother who gives birth to a child who would become a bhakta, a devotee of God, who would bring happiness to those with whom he would come into contact with. What wonderful lessons, my dear friends, that he speaks to Ravan. Indeed, it is said in this bhajan,
Vaishnava jan to tini kahi jo peer parai jani re.
That individual, that devotee who shares in the pain of another, who shares the sorrow of another, who destroys all pride and abhiman, who speaks not a word of evil against anyone, blessed is that mother who have given birth to such a child who looks upon all and everyone as his equal. He has renounced pride and abhiman, whose tongue constantly chants the name of Sri Ram. He has conquered greed. He is free from deceit, lust and anger. Through him, dharma is propagated. This wonderful bhajan, my dear friends, captures all the wonderful advice that Hanumanji gives to Ravan.
Vaishnava janato tini kahi je peer parai jani re. Vaishnava janato tini kahi je peer parai jani re. Kar dukho upkar kare koi, kar dukho upkar kare koi, man abhiman na jani re. Vaishnava janato sakal lok ma sahune vande ninda kariye ki mere. Sakal lok ma sahune vande ninda kariye ki mere. Baach man nishchay rakhe, baach man nishchay rakhe. Vaishnava janato tini kahi je. Samdrishti ne Krishna tyagi parishri je. Samadrishti ne Krishna tyagi parishri je ne matre. Jivyadati asatya na bole, Jivyadati asatya na bole, Parthan nav chale khatre. Vaishnava jan to tere kahiye je.
And the bhajan ends off by saying that when such a child is given to this world, who is a devotee of God, who never speaks ill of another, who never brings harm and distress and difficulty to another, who never hurts and steals from another, who shares in the pain and sorrows of others, such a child brings salvation to his generation. That is, even those who have died and gone before him, the parents and grandparents, great-grandparents, all share, my dear friends, in the punya, the benefit of someone who would live such a life of distinction. So what happens when the opposite occurs? Like a Ravan. I know there are many children today who embrace the traditions of their family, who follow the respect and honor of that family. And yet, my dear friends, unfortunately, there are many others who trample upon the ideals of that family, who discard the traditions, the culture, the religious practices of that family. Then what becomes of such a situation? Unfortunately, my dear friends, the bad actions and the sinfulness of that one child brings down the entire generation. It has an effect, my dear friends, not just upon the parents who are alive, but even those who have gone before. My dear friends, it affects them in their journey. And wherever they may be, whatever look, whatever situation that they may have their abode, my dear friends, such sinful actions of the present generation can also affect those who have gone before. This is why, my dear friends, the issue of parenting comes in, and how, you know, we ensure that we teach our children well, that when they would grow up to be adults, they would be the ones who would support us, encourage us, assist us. You know that when you have to perform puja, the children wouldn't find something more important to do and leave the home. It happens, you know. Sometimes you go to do puja and you ask, so where are the children? You say, well, Baba, they're busy. This one had to go out. This one had to meet a friend. This one had to go shopping. Really? On the day of the puja? My dear friends, in many, many situations, you know, The children today, many of them are discarding and not embracing the wonderful legacy of culture and religion that our parents and grandparents have left behind. And so the words of Hanuman Swami is applicable as to us as well. Your actions, O Hanumanji, would become a blot, a stain upon the name of your grandfather, the great sage Pulaschamuni. So, Ravan is very angry now. Let us listen in this Chaupai what he decides to do with Hanuman Swami. Sunat kapi manamusukana bhai sahay sharar mai jana jatu dhan suni ravan bachana lage rahai mood soi rachana. Quickly Ravan shouted at his soldiers, put this vanar to death. After Hanumanji had spoken to him all the wonderful words, even angrier. And so, my dear friends, even as he shouted out this order, many of his soldiers rushed forward with swords upraised, weapons in the air, obeying the instructions of their king, Ravan, to put to death Hanuman Swami. It is Vibhishan who intervened and said, O Ravan, remember, Vibhishan is a brother of Ravan. It is against all sound doctrines to slay a messenger. He, Hanumanji, is just a messenger of your enemy, Sri Ram. Allow him to return with a message to his master, Sri Ram. And then someone suggested, let us burn his tail. And when Hanumanji heard that suggestion, he smiled. O Saraswati Mata, he's saying to himself that indeed your blessings have been bestowed upon me. This is what he was waiting for, my dear friends. Ravan thought this was an excellent idea to burn the tail of Hanumanji. And so he requested them, bring some ghee and some cotton. Bring some cloth and let us wrap this tail and soak it with the ghee and set it alight. And so, my dear friends, all arrangements were made. They brought what they thought was enough cotton and ghee and so on to wrap his tail. But they found that despite having sufficient amount of cotton and cloth and so on, yet it was too less. What had happened? Hanumanji began to expand his tail. So he decided, Ravan said, bring some more. And so this they did, my dear friends. They brought some more cloth and cotton. But no matter how much they brought, my dear friends, this tail continued to expand. It demonstrates and highlights to us that Bhagwan is beyond measure. Bhagwan is beyond confinement. Earlier we read, Sri Ram was flying a kite when he was a boy, a little baby, a child. And that kite passed the roof of the palace, it passed the treetops, and then disappeared into the clouds. Similarly, that symbolizes that Bhagwan is omniscient. His reach, my dear friends, his power is not limited as we are limited. Here again, Hanumanji is demonstrating this very same lesson to us. And so, my dear devotees, eventually they brought all the ghee and all the cotton in Lanka and well soaked that tail, that continuously expanding tail of Hanuman Swami. And then, my dear friends, beating drums and clapping and singing, the demons took great delight in doing this, you know. Unaware of what disaster lay ahead of them, they are clapping gleefully, beating drums and dancing and singing, my dear friends. And as his tail was set alight, Pavan Devata blew the winds in 49 winds, my dear friends, began to blow. And so what happened? Something like a cyclone. You know, sometimes you get winds from the east, winds from the north. In fact, winds blow in all different directions. And here Ramayana Katha tells us that 49 different winds began to blow at the same time. Now what happens, devotees, when you light fire and the wind begins to blow very strong? The wind is like fuel to the fire. And so what happened? As he assumed this huge form with a very long tail, my dear friends, as his tail was set alight, he, Hanuman Swami, began to jump from building to building. His tail acted like a torch. As he would jump from this building to the other, my dear friends, he would set the building alight. And as Pavan Devata blew this powerful gust of wind in these 49 directions, my dear friends, the circulation that resulted caused this fire to spread very rapidly. Those who were dancing and clapping and singing before now began to scamper in fear. Lanka was ablaze. Hanumanji, my dear friends, despite his very huge form that he assumed to burn Lanka, to set alight Lanka, was very nimble. After he set these buildings alight, my dear friends, he went into the ocean and extinguished that fire that was burning on his tail. The devis and devatas who witnessed this miracle, began to sing the glories of Shri Hanuman Swami.
Bole bole Hanuman, bolo bhakto siyaram, Shri Ram ke charno me bante bigri kaam. Bole bole Hanuman, bolo bhakto siyaram, Shri Ram. उसकी शोभा है विष्णु में, उसकी शोभा है मोहन सी, उसकी शोभा है विष्णु में, उसकी शोभा है मोहन सी। तुलसी ने जब शीश झुकाया, मनुष्य बन ही कान्हा की अंशी। राम ही माया राम ही जान, तन तन में श्री राम। बोले बोले हनुमान, बोलो भक्त सिया राम, श्री राम के चरणों में बन गए बिगड़ी काम। बोले बोले हनुमान, बोलो भक्त सिया राम।
श्री पवन पुत्र हनुमान की जय। बोल बजरंग बली की जय। There's a beautiful, you know, movie, a beautiful video that shows Hanuman Swami performing all of these miracles. You have it on DVD. You have it online. You know, the children, our children are very fond of Superman and Batman and Spider-Man. What about Hanuman? Hanuman Swami was doing all of these miracles long before you had Superman and Batman and Spider-Man and so on. The only difference is these characters could only do it on the camera. What you call camera tricks, isn't it? Hanuman Swami actually did it. Flying across the ocean, my dear friends, jumping from one building to the other, setting the buildings alight. And in a previous night's katha, of course, we explained how he is able to do this, and we outlined the ashta siddhi, or the eight perfections, the eight powers that he possesses, my dear friends, that enables him to perform all of these miracles. And so, my dear friends, when Lanka was ablaze in this manner, finally he went into the ocean and extinguished his tail that was still on fire. He went back to Sita Devi and reassured her, "O mother, very soon Sri Ram will arrive in Lanka with his entire army to destroy you, Ravan, and of course restore you to safety." My dear friends, having done so, Hanumanji left, he departed Ayodhya, he left Lanka and headed towards Ayodhya to once again meet with Sri Ramchandra. where, my dear friends, the construction of the bridge, what is called the Setu Bandh, began to take place. We'll wind up our katha with this beautiful bhajan, as when he arrived back there in Ayodhya, all were very joyous and happy to see him, and of course to learn of his victory in Lanka.
Mahabir banke ranbir banke chali aana bajrangi chali aana Mahabir banke ranbir banke chali aana bajrangi chali aana साथ लेके चली आना बजरंगी चली आना महावीर बनके रणवीर बनके चली आना बजरंगी चली आना साथ लेके चली आना बजरंगी चली आना महावीर बनके रणवीर बनके चली आना बजरंगी चली आना तुम वज्र रूप में आना शक्ति साथ लेके चली आना बजरंगी चली आना महावीर बनके रणवीर बनके चली आना बजरंगी चली आना
have inherited this great name, Mahavir. Mahavir literally translates into that great and powerful warrior. What have we done with the name? Instead of Mahavir, this is Mahabir. It's a big bear. We, my dear friends, you know, many of our names, you know, comes directly from our scriptures. And we must honor, just as Hanumanji is saying, you know, that you honor your ancestors, O Ravan. Do not become a blot, a stain on the name. of your grandfather Pulaschamuni. We are the ones, my dear friends, who have inherited these great names, this great legacy that we read in our text. Mahavir, the great name of Hanuman Swami, my dear friends.